This is Leadership Plus. I'm Dave Edwards. I spent the majority of my professional career working in the nonprofit sector, public radio to be specific. And I've been on the air during public radio fund drives, you know, the begathons that are so very popular. And I've pitched the value of contributing to my organization. And, we've typically offered incentives, different premiums. I have quite a collection. These are only three. I can only hold three of them. I have quite a collection of coffee mugs that have been given away. I also have a bunch of t-shirts. I wear most of them. And I have a lot of other things that not only my former radio station would give away, but other nonprofits that I support would send me. And some of the incentives that I'm sent, I never use. I got a book recently that, quite frankly, I'm never going to read. Thank you, organization. That was very nice of you to send it to me. But quite honestly, I kind of wished you had kept all of my money and put it towards the program that I support. And it is very common in the nonprofit sector to offer incentives or premiums to encourage people to contribute. There's a widely held belief that it's those incentives that will move somebody from just a casual observer to a contributor. And I guess it works, or at least nonprofits think it works, because the promotional product industry in this country is huge. I saw a statistic here. It's a $24 billion industry in the United States. It's a lot of coffee mugs. But what if nonprofits tried something very different? What if instead of giving me a t-shirt or a book or a coffee mug, they offered me an experience? Our local zoological society has a regular banquet where they auction off items to the highest bidder. And one of the more popular ones is a behind-the-scenes tour of the zoo. And I was able to do that once. I even got to feed a giraffe. Never thought I'd have that opportunity. But that was an experience that happened years ago. I'm still talking about it. Am I talking about that t-shirt that I got? Probably not. So that really got me thinking, what can nonprofit organizations do to move me from casual observer to a contributor? Now, I realize the zoo can't give thousands of tours behind the scenes to all of its members who contribute. But you know, they might be able to offer people the opportunity to attend a lecture from one of the zookeepers, or maybe see a video of the way some of the animals are taken care of. That would appeal to me. How would that work for a public radio station? Maybe instead of sending me a coffee mug or a tote bag, they might let a certain number of donors observe the taping of a very popular radio program. I'd love it if the local theater group gave me an opportunity to meet and talk with an actor or even someone who does set design or costume design. That would be a great experience. Admittedly, it would take time to coordinate all these special experiences, but when you consider the rising cost of postage, the rising cost of purchasing all of these items, you see the point I'm trying to get at? What is the most effective use of the premium, the incentive program that a nonprofit organization operates? I'm willing to bet that these non-traditional ideas will actually build more loyalty to the nonprofit organizations that experiments and takes a chance at offering them. Just an idea. If you work for a nonprofit, it's something you might want to consider. That's today's Leadership Plus. I'm Dave Edwards. Please like this video, subscribe if you please, and if you want to see more articles on leadership, management, and productivity, please visit my website at daveedwardsmedia.com.